Hi students, welcome back to our science classes. And now we are continuing our lesson metals and non-metals. Now let's learn the reaction of metal with water. So now we are going to learn about how metals react with water. Equation is given here. Metals plus oxygen gives metal oxide or metal hydroxide plus hydrogen. It says that metal react with water, then we get either metal oxide or metal hydroxide plus hydrogen. Anyway, hydrogen gas, it will be formed. So along with the hydrogen, it will form either metal oxide or metal hydroxide. As we have done earlier, to understand this, let us perform an activity. For perform this activity, we need sodium metal, a knife, beaker, water and filter paper. So these are the things we needed. Let us begin the experiment. First we can take a small piece of sodium. So with the help of the knife, we can cut a small piece of sodium. Sodium is one soft metal. Sodium is a soft metal, we can cut with the help of a knife. So we can take a very small piece of sodium. That means we can take the sodium in the size of a wheat grain. That much small quantity of sodium is enough to do this experiment. Okay, after that it will be wet. That means always sodium will be kept in kerosene. Sodium is the metal that always it will be preserved in kerosene. The reason is that if we kept in air, suddenly it will react with oxygen, and if it kept in water, it will react violently. That means it can cause fire accidents. Very violently it will react with water. For this reasons, usually sodium we kept or preserved under kerosene. So now we can take a small piece of sodium, we can blot or we can make it dry with the help of filter paper, because on the surface of the sodium there will be kerosene, so we can make it dry with the help of filter paper. Okay, now we can take one beaker. In the beaker we can take water. So we have taken water in the beaker, and to this water carefully we can drop this sodium. Care should be taken. If you have dropped it fast, there it can cause the fire accident. So slowly we can drop the piece of sodium on the surface of water. We can see that sodium moves in water with a hissing sound and it finishes up. That means sodium reacts with water and it finishes up. So if you added more sodium, what happens? It may cause fire explosion. It can cause accidents. Very violently sodium reacts with water. So when the reaction take place, it is better to be move away from the beaker. So once the reaction is stopped, that means when all the sodium has been burned in water, now just you can touch the beaker. When we touch the beaker, we can feel that the water will be hot. Okay, now our next step, what is that? We can bring blue litmus paper and red litmus paper. Both we can treat with this solution. So in the first case, if you bring a red litmus paper, we can see that it changes to blue. Red litmus paper has been changed to blue, and when we bring blue, there will be no change with blue litmus paper. So only it changes a red litmus to blue. If it changes red litmus to blue, what is its meaning? It means that the solution is basic in nature. The solution is basic in nature. And also we can see the reaction take place, sodium finishes up, as well as we can see there will be number of bubbles in water. Large number of bubbles in water we can see. That bubbles are nothing but that is hydrogen. What is that? That is hydrogen. Now how can we test the presence of hydrogen? This part is important. It may ask the question, how do you test the presence of hydrogen? To test the presence of hydrogen, what we can do, we can bring a burning splinter. If the burning splinter is not available, we can bring a burning matchstick near the mouth of the beaker. So when you bring it near the mouth of the beaker, that gas, the bubbles that burns with a pop sound. We can see that burns with a pop sound. If a gas burns with a pop sound, it indicates that, or it confirms that gas is hydrogen. If a gas burns with a pop sound, it means that the gas is hydrogen. So we can understand that the gas formed here is hydrogen. So let us know the chemistry behind this reaction. So we have taken sodium. The sodium has been treated with water, sodium plus water. Then we get sodium hydroxide. What we got? Sodium hydroxide. What is the nature of sodium hydroxide? Sodium hydroxide is basic in nature. Sodium hydroxide is basic in nature. That is why color of the red, it must changes to blue. And hydrogen gas is evolved. We tested the presence of hydrogen gas by bringing a burning mastic. Then we found that it burns with a pop sound. So we confirmed that the gas formed is hydrogen. This is the chemistry behind this experiment. Now let us do another activity. For doing this activity, we need a magnesium ribbon, we need test tube, cold water and hot water. These are the things we required. First, we can take some cold water in a test tube, and to this cold water we can add a piece of cleaned magnesium ribbon. We can wait for some time. So after some times, we can see that there will be small bubbles will be appeared there. We can see small bubbles around the magnesium rubber. Now we can take another test tube. In another test tube, we can, instead of cold water, we can take some hot water. We have taken hot water, and to this hot water we can add one magnesium ribbon. So when we added the magnesium ribbon, we can note that around the magnesium ribbon so many bubbles we can see. After that, we can test this solution where we kept the magnesium ribbon. We can test it with both red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. So in this case also, we will find that the blue litmus paper will remain unchanged and the red litmus paper changes to blue. If the red litmus paper changes to blue, it means that it is basic in nature. And one more thing you can note here, magnesium reacts very slowly with cold water and very vigorously with hot water. Magnesium reacts vigorously with hot water. And let us know what is the chemistry behind this. So we have taken magnesium and we treated with water. Magnesium plus water, we got magnesium oxide. Usually magnesium won't form magnesium hydroxide when it reacts with water. So when the magnesium reacts with the water, it forms magnesium oxide and it forms hydrogen gas. If we want to test the presence of hydrogen gas, we know how can we test. Bring the burning splinter, then the gas burns with a pop sound, then we will confirm that the formed gas is hydrogen. But previously we have seen the experiment that was sodium and water. When sodium reacts with the water, the formed one was sodium hydroxide. But when magnesium reacts with water, it forms magnesium hydroxide. Anyway, one thing is clear, there hydrogen gas will be evolved. Now let's learn how non-metals react with water. So we have learned how metals reacted with water. Now we are going to learn about how non-metal react with water. So for that, we can take some sulfur powder and test tube and some water. These are only these things required. In a test tube, we can take the water. To this water, we can add some sulfur powder. When we added the sulfur powder to water, we can see that it does not change. There will be no reaction. Instead of sulfur, we can take any other non-metal. So we will find that usually non-metals don't react with water, or there will be no reaction between non-metal and water. So we can summarize it like this: non-metal plus water, there won't be any reaction. Usually non-metals won't react with water.